ఇంకా డిఫరెంట్ గా ఎవరైనా ఏమైనా చెప్తారా? ఆల్ టీమ్ మెంబర్స్ షేర్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్. ఓకే ఓకే. సో హియర్ విల్ సి టుడేస్ టాపిక్ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు స్టార్ట్ లైక్ కలెక్టివ్ కోడ్ ఓనర్షిప్. మెయిన్లీ హియర్ యూ కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ బై రీడింగ్ దిస్ హెడ్డింగ్ కలెక్టివ్ కోడ్ ఓనర్షిప్ మీన్స్ everyone will be involving in that and everyone is having a right to change the code and to update, right? So there will be a no owner. Okay, everyone can do any changes from anywhere. Okay, if necessary requirements or depend upon the requirements they want to do the changes in that particular code, means definitely they can do, right? So collective code ownership, has you people said that, okay, like working on the code or maintaining the code, designing the code, okay, upgrading all the things, okay, whatever the changes you want you can do, okay, from anywhere. So making collective ownership work is exactly sounds like everyone shares the responsibility. Why they will be sharing this responsibility means to get a quality of code. Right, to get a quality of code. Here everyone is involving, everyone is sharing their ideas, means definitely we can build a good code, right? That is a good quality of code, right? And here whenever we people are developing any code, here no single person claims the ownership, right, over any part of the system, and anyone can make any necessary changes from any way, right? Here no one is the owner of that code. If you feel that this code is not proper and this design is not proper, in better way you want to plan, okay, if you are planning the better way and good quality of code, definitely you can do the changes for that, right? Here that's why we are saying that no single person is owner for that particular system. Anyone can make any changes from any where, right? Simply here collective code ownership is nothing but everyone have to be involved, first thing. Second thing, everyone have to share the responsibility, should not push the total work on the one person, right? If everyone is involving, sharing their ideas, sharing their talents or thoughts, then definitely we can get a good quality of code or good quality of product, right? If we feel that code is not good, then we can do the changes for that code also, right? This is possible in this collective code ownership, right? So next, working with unfamiliar code, right? So whenever you people are working in projects, ma, whatever the code you people have written, that all the code you know, okay, how that code is working, what are the things involved in that, right? So unknown things you people are not going to be involved in that, right? So mikum, if you people are unable to write the code on some other thing, okay, on some other language, okay, whatever you know, you people are involving and you people are writing that code, right? So you people are not going to be working with unfamiliar code. If you people are going to be involved in that, involving that unfamiliar code, means here everyone won't understand, only one or two people will be understanding, so it will be becoming a problematic to us, right? So we have to explain for them and they won't, they unable to understand about that, and these all issues will be creating, right? Simply we can say that if you are working on a project where only one or two people understand, then collective code ownership might or does not work, right? So everyone have to involve, as we discussed, they have to share the responsibility, then only we can say that it is a collective code ownership, everyone will be understanding, right? Like that. So whatever we know, if we know that is enough, okay, I know everything now, that is enough, I will be working, don't do that all things on your projects when you people are working. Just try to involve everyone as you people are working with your major project, right? Here whoever the team lead is there, he have to work, he have to do the documentation, you should not do like that, okay? You have to share the responsibility. If you are having any ideas, you have to share and thoughts also you have to share, Like this, you can distribute your work, right? And everyone is having the same right to change the code also. If you know well, you can change, right? You can. If you won't understand and the things are not good, okay, for the better quality of the product, if you want to improve that code quality also, you can involve in that and you can do the changes, right? So finally, what will be the results for this collective code ownership? Means when you practice collective code ownership, you constantly make minor improvements to all the parts of that code base or database, right? So whenever you people are practicing, definitely we will be doing some small changes, updating the code or updating something else into that project or a code. Like that we are doing. But definitely we are improving that product code, right? Product to get a good quality of code, right? So find that code you have written improves without your help. Right? When a team member leaves or takes a vacation, the rest of the team continues to be productive, right? So why here they will be saying that everyone have to be knowledge in that particular code or particular software? Means if anyone happened or if anything happened, okay, if they are in vacation or if they left that organization, so that the other persons can continue from that work, okay? Like that, for that purpose only they will be involving everyone and sharing their thoughts and whatever the known, okay, majority, based upon that majority they will be selecting that particular code in which language we have to write, like that, right? So that will be the results. And what will be the contradictions? So collective code ownerships requires good communication. Until unless if you won't involve in that, if you won't share the thoughts or ideas, then we can't, right? Okay, without it, the team cannot maintain a shared vision and code quality will suffer, right? Obviously, however you people are forming as a 4-in project team, right? If only one person is working, means how it will be, it will be critical, okay, whatever he knows he will be doing, he or she. Right. If everyone will be involving, sharing their ideas, thoughts, definitely we can improve the code quality. Otherwise, it will be suffering, right? So what will be the alternatives? If communication is not possible, then what will be the alternatives? If you cannot use collective code ownership, you need to adapt other techniques, right, to spread the knowledge and encourage the refactoring. Okay, whatever the changes you are doing, you have to encourage them, and whatever the things you people are updating, you have to choose some other thing, right, for that, right? So this will be the alternate use for this collective code ownership, right? So mainly this collective code ownership is going to be spreading like a responsibility and maintaining the code for all the programmers, mainly maintaining the code for the programmers, right, to improve the product quality or the code quality, right? So it is the responsibility of each and every member who are involving and working in that project. They have to share these all things for the quality of code, right? So in the second thing, what we have discussed, no person is owner of that particular code, right? Everyone can involve and can make the necessary changes from anywhere. Why necessary changes? Means to improve the code quality, right? So this is the important part in this collective code ownership. Okay, if we involve in that, okay, so collective ownership allows mainly like no experts, everyone to fix the problems, okay? Only one person have to work, okay? He will be fixing the problem, he will be checking. These all things, not like that. Everyone, if you find a problem, if you find any difficulties in that, you can change, okay, like that. If you encounter any duplications, unclear the names, or even poorly designed code, it doesn't matter who wrote it, right? It's your code, fix it. Okay, we should not depend on the other, let them, other person will be coming and he will be fixing. Okay, I will be just posting the code, they will be checking these all things. These all things you should not do like that in projects. Whenever you people are working in MNC companies or in particular projects as a team, right? So how it will be making a work with this collective ownership? First of all, there should be a commitment from the team members, right? So why commitment means to get a good code, okay, good quality of code. Means how to get good quality of code? Whenever we are checking the code or working on that particular code, if we get any problem, try to fix and solve that problem there itself only, right? And try to write the new code, right? And don't do a half-hearted jobs and assume somebody else will fix your mistakes, okay? No one will be fixing your mistake. You only the responsible for that, okay? If you find anything, any problem or any defect, immediately you have to replace that, right, by using some refactoring technique. So the main thing is that you have to write the best code, right? On other hand, collective ownership means you don't have to be perfect. You don't have to be perfect. Whatever you know, you write. Okay, everyone will be involved in sharing their responsibilities. Okay, they will be also helping. But simultaneously, you have to work there, right? If you have produced code that works, is of reasonable quality, and you aren't not sure how to make it better, don't hesitate to let it go. Someone else will improve it later when it needs it, right? So whenever you people are posting any code into the repositories, from your moving the data from sandbox to the repositories, whenever they are running, okay, they are checking, okay, raising some tokens or some issues. If there are any defects, they will be fixing that, okay? If that defect has been not solved, they will be tagging that and giving the information if anyone is having any idea about that bug or a defect, so that they can share their ideas, okay? Like that, they will be improving the code quality in this collective code ownerships. And here, mainly thing is working with unfamiliar code. Whenever you don't know about that code, don't involve that code, okay? Don't include that code into that particular product or a particular projects, right? Whatever you know, you have to work on that, right? If any problems arise, try to fix that, okay? And everyone have to share the idea, share the responsibility. Then only we can produce a good quality of work, right? So with these all things, there will be some hidden benefits, ma'am, right? With this collective ownership code, here there will be some benefits, like some hidden benefits in the sense, here everyone will be sharing the responsibility. And if anything happens, if anyone, any other person founds that, they will be fixing, okay? If they understand, they will be doing the changes, right? So these all things will be added as some advantages so that we can improve our product quality, right? So this is about the collective code ownership, right? Collective code ownership means everyone have to involve in that, and they have to share their information, right? And they have to work on that particular things, right?